The President, please be seated.
Le Président, Mesdames et Messieurs, veuillez
the
vous asseoir.
The trial chamber is back in
Nous
session.
Nous reprenons l'audience.
And the defense counsel.
Et nous redonnons la parole
the floor
au conseil de la défense.
Your final submission, please. The floor is yours. I would like now
Maître
to start.
Kassabout.
In conclusion,
je reprends.
Those
en conclusion,
who were most responsible
les principaux
for
responsables
the
des crimes et graves violations
of the Cambodian
du droit national
and international
et
law
international
during
commis
the period from
durant
17
la période
April 1975
du 30
to 6 January 1979,
du 17 avril 1975 au 6 janvier 1979.
One,
représente
Pol
11 personnes.
Nunchie,
un Pol Pot, 2 Nunchia, 3 Sao Yan
alias
Pim, 4 Ung Chun alias Mok, 5 Son Sen, 6 Kyo Sampan, 7 Men San alias Ya, 8 Chu Shed alias Si, 9 Wos Nim, 10 Kei Pok, 11 Kan Chap alias Se.
I have just address to the court about the
Je
stages of the
présenter à la cour
purges.
Les phases I would like now to purges.
Start
Je vais
from
aborder ce point
the
dans
17
la chambre
April
et je souhaiterais
to
parler à présent
January
du cumul des deux périodes allant du 17 avril 1975 au 6 janvier 1979.
Responsible, most
les
responsible
principaux
for the
responsables des crimes et
and international law during the
grave
period
violation
of
du droit national et du droit international commis durant la période du 17 avril 1975 au 6 janvier 1979,
Pol Pot,
représente 13 personnes, Pol Pot, Nunchia, Soryan, Ung Chun,
Kyu Sampon,
Von Fett, Sun Sen, Kyu Sampan, Koi Tun, Men San,
alias
Ya, Chu Chet,
alias
Si,
Rot Nim,
Ke Pok, Kam Chap alias Se.
In conclusion,
en conclusion,
among those who
parmi
were most responsible
les principaux
for the
responsables
and
des crimes
serious violations
et graves violations
of the Cambodian
du droit national
and
et du droit international
during the period
pendant la
of
période
the period from 17 April
du 17 avril 1975 au 6 janvier
the 6th of January 1979 and
sont ici présentés et Do Kangekyo ne compte pas parmi ces 13 personnes mentionnées ci-dessus.
Under Article 1
selon l'article 1 de la loi portant création des CETC
because he was not a senior leader of the Democratic Cambodia
car il n'était pas
and he was not those who
un des hauts dirigeants du Cambodia démocratique il n'est pas non plus parmi les principaux responsables des crimes et graves violations du droit national et du droit international
from the 17th of April 1975
durant la période du 17 avril 1975 au 6 janvier 1979.
In conclusion,
en conclusion,
who were senior leaders
qui étaient
of
les hauts dirigeants du Cambodia démocratique
and
et
those who were most
les principaux responsables
and
des crimes et graves violations du droit national et international,
and international law from 17 April 1975
commis durant la période du 17 avril 1975 au 6 janvier 1979.
And I would like to combine together of the senior leader of the DK
combiner
and those
la liste
who were most
des hauts dirigeants du Cambodia démocratique et les principaux
but
responsables
in this case,
en une liste,
some of
en l'espèce, certaines
play two roles.
Ces personnes ont joué deux rôles, avec deux chapeaux. Il y avait d'un côté les hauts dirigeants, c'était des personnes qui étaient à la fois hauts dirigeants et principaux, comptant parmi les principaux responsables. Certains étaient hauts dirigeants et d'autres n'étaient que principaux responsables, n'entraient que dans une de ces deux catégories.
So, those who were the senior leader of the Democratic Cambodia and those who were most responsible for the crimes,
altogether,
there were only 14 of them. 14 of them.
On ne compte que 13
on the top,
d'entre eux.
He is
14 d'entre eux,
the most senior leader.
Tout d'abord,
and the most responsible person
la personne
for the crimes
la principale responsable
the law and international
crimes,
law,
le principal responsable des crimes et le plus haut dirigeant.
Of them.
Parmi ces plus hauts dirigeants et ces principaux responsables,
so on roles,
compte 9 personnes.
Of them,
ceux
one
qui jouaient,
part.
Il y avait un double rôle.
Two, Nguyen Chi.
Il n'y en avait que 9. Tout d'abord, Pon Pot, 2 Nguyen Chi A, 3 Saoyan alias Pim, 4 Ong Chun alias Mok,
5 Von Wet,
2 Cheng, 5 Von Wet, 6 Son Sen.
So I would like to address to the court that 7, 8 et 9,
la chambre que les personnes 7, 8 et 9, les trois dernières personnes sur cette liste, à la lumière de des documents historiques,
the 7, Kyu Sampon, Kaepok et Nan Rosnim.
Kaepok et Nan Rosnim sur cette liste.
Secondly,
nous arrivons donc à 9 personnes. Deuxièmement,
senior leaders. He was not
pour
the
ce qui
one
est
who is
des hauts dirigeants et non pas
for the crime.
Principaux responsables
he
des
was
crimes.
Yan Sari.
Il y a dans cette catégorie Yan Sari.
So those who were most responsible
et
for all the crimes altogether, I may now conclude that there were four of them who were not the senior leaders, but they were those who were responsible for the crimes. Number one, Koytun, Mansan, alias Ya, Chu Chet, alias Si, Kong Chap, alias Sai. So these 14 individuals,
nous arrivons ici à une liste comprenant 14 individus,
were executed or summarized before the 6th of January 1979. So 7 out of 14 died before the 6th of January 1979. They include Cao Yan, alias Pem, committed suicide in 1978. Won Wei, alias Peng Tuk, arrested on the 2nd of November 1978 and smashed in the same year. Tri Koytun, arrested on the 25th of January 1977. 4 Man San, alias Ya, arrested 20th of September 76. 5 Chu Chet, alias C, arrested 17 April 1978. 6 Ruos Nhâm, alias Mul Un, alias Sambat, smashed 1978. 7 Kong Chap, alias Sai, alias Chan Som, was arrested and smashed on the 31st of October 1978.
B
were executed or died after the 6th of January 1979. There were four of them, including Pol Pot, who died in 1998,
two, Ong Chun, alias
Mok, died in 2006, Son Sen, number three, was master by Pol Pot in 1997. Four, Kai Pok died in 2002. So among these 14 people, 11 of whom died, three remain to be brought to trial. Number one, Nguyen Chia, senior leader of the Democratic Cambodia as the first secretary and the most responsible person for the crime and serious violations of the domestic and international law, as Nguyen Chia was the one who oversaw the implementation of the policies and decisions rendered by Pol Pot. He was ruling or monitoring the ministers of four main ministries, including the purchase of the four ministries, including the Secretary of the East, and whose secretary was purged earlier. Number two, Kyu Sampan was the most responsible person for the crimes and violations of the domestic and international law. Kyu Sampan was the secretary of Office 870, who had the authority to smash anyone surrounding the central office. Kyu Sampan became the standing committee member in 1977, so he was part of the system. Number three, Yang Sari, who was the most senior leader of the Democratic Cambodia, because he was the minister, the deputy prime minister, in charge of foreign affairs.
En charge des affaires étrangères.
Was not the senior leader of the Democratic Cambodia,
nor was he dirigeant du Cambodia démocratique,
classified
et n'était pas
in
non
the
plus
category of those who were most responsible for crimes and serious violations of domestic and international law.
Because
the senior leaders of the Khmer Rouge regime, the Democratic
Cambodia, les hauts dirigeants du Cambodge démocratique,
comprise only those people, and that Dutch
cette personne
had not been included.
Et le nom de Duc
the
ne
three additional members of the standing committee
catégorie
were included, and Dutch was never been included.
Dans la liste que j'ai
regarding those who were most responsible for the
Duc
crimes
pas non plus parmi les and the serious violations des crimes of the domestic du droit national and international
law, I can conclude there were only 13 people, among them Dutch
cette catégorie
was not
13
listed
personnes, et parmi lesquelles ne figure pas le nom de Kengekiv alias
in
Duc.
Thousands of pages of document
parmi
in the case
milliers
file,
de page
there
de
is
document,
no document,
dossier, aucun document
indicating that Deutsch as the
Duc
senior leader or those who was most responsible for the crime.
Un haut dirigeant du Cambodge démocratique ou l'un des principaux responsables
Deutsch
des
only
dix
was mostly responsible
que
for
le
the crimes
responsable
at S21.
Les crimes commis à S21.
So those who were sent to S21 were under the supervision of Deutsch.
Ils s'occupaient des personnes envoyées à S21.
And these could only be exercised in the confinement area of S21.
Que dans le périmètre de S21.
So Dutch's responsibilities was to hold the prisoners and not to allow any of them to escape,
les
to torture
les
them,
to
extract
de les
their confessions,
de recueillir leurs aveux,
to determine whether they were
afin de déterminer si
obtained and genuinely obtained. Otherwise, he would be in big trouble.
Ces
and to determine whether they were CIA, KGB agents, or UN spies, whoever it is, not to let them die,
and de la CIA, du KGB, ou espion
confessions.
L'objectif était de maintenir les prisonniers en vie afin de ne pas perdre d'aveu.
Cut off. If anyone was found to have tortured the victim,
On avait torturé.
At that time, they were called as detainees, and if the they died and their confessions were cut off, then Deutsche would be responsible for that.
Eh bien, c'est la responsabilité incombée à
Deutsche was responsible to.
Deutsche était
send the prisoners who or the victims who were already interrogated to be smashed.
Duc never executed those people
in person.
Aucune de ces personnes.
So to smash the prisoners for them means to smash as ordered by Aung Kyaw, whose leader was Pol Pot, the top leader, who issued orders to Nguyen Chi and Son Sen, who then issued orders to Deutsche, who, in turn, issued orders to the smashing squad.
Pol Pot, puis Son Sen.
This confirms that Deutsche was not one of those who were most responsible, as Deutsche received orders from his superiors, who had the authority to make decisions on smashing, as well as the authority to order the smashing accordingly. So it is they who were most responsible.
A person who received orders and executed them
is not one of those who were most responsible, as in fact
he was ordered from above. En fait, donc, so someone ordered from his above. Par conséquent, c'était les supérieurs qui transmettaient les ordres.
So Deutsch would have been one of those who were most responsible if he were vested with the authority to order other people to make arrests and smash those who were arrested.
S'il avait disposé du pouvoir d'ordonner les arrestations et les liquidations.
And since he had no authority to smash, and he had nothing to choose but to obey the order, otherwise, or to kill or be killed.
Tuer ou être tué. Telle était sa position.
Whether the chairman of S21 was regarded as the senior or those who were most responsible for the crimes and serious violations of international and domestic law is still in question. So in the Khmer Rouge regime, there were 196 prisons. And there were 196 prison chiefs.
So, Deutsche alone, 196 autres chefs de centre de détention,
shall not be charged if the other prisoner chiefs still enjoyed the impunity.
Les autres chefs de centre de détention,
so, in conclusion, it would be fair enough if all these people are arrested and brought to trials. And according to the Constitution, Article 31 of the Constitution of the Kingdom of Cambodia, the article clearly states that every Khmer citizen shall be equal before the law, enjoying the same rights, freedom, and fulfilling the same obligation regardless of the race, color, sex, language, religious belief, political tendency. Is there equality there here? Is Article 31 of the Constitution of the Kingdom of Cambodia being respected
when amongst the 196 prison chairmen,
only the S21 prison chairman is being
ici,
prosecuted.
Le chef de la prison de S21 est
the
poursuivi
other 195 prison chairmen remain free.
Each prison received the same orders from the same ANCA,
and each prison implemented the same system of torture and killing. Why
Deutsch
the only one being prosecuted? Is justice being done by the ECCC with the involvement of the United Nations?
More concretely,
only 64 of the 196 prisons have statistics showing the number of people who died.
S21 ranks
number
10. Car nous ne disposons pas de données pour l'ensemble de ces centres de détention, 16-21 arrive au 10e rang de prisonniers exécutés.
By comparison,
par comparaison,
Chongchroy prison, located
à la prison
in
de Chongchroy, située dans le village de Choktrak, commune de Kuk Ban Thai, district de Rolai Bia,
district in Kampong Chnang province.
Kampong Chnang,
the number of people killed was significantly higher than the number of those killed at S21. Despite all
malgré
that,
cela,
the chairman of that prison has not been prosecuted.
Le directeur de cette prison
so
n'a
the
pas
number
été
of people killed at S21 was far less than those people who died and
who
were killed at the Chongchroy prison. So why the prison chief who ordered the execution of 12,000 victims is being brought
alors
to justice. I know the co-prosecutor would wish
that
justice is done, but the defense counsel wants justice to be done to the accused too.
Justice soit rendue et que l'on puisse percevoir que la justice
I'm
est
now
rendue.
Talking
mais,
about the damages.
L'accusé est également dans cette
and
perspective,
by comparing the number of prisoners who were killed at that prison and those who were killed at S21, so you can see the lives, the number of lives who perished.
On peut établir une comparaison.
But please, I would like to apologize to everyone that I'm not really downgrading the dignity of the dead soul of the more than 12,000 people who died at S21. Among the
12,208
prisoners died, as compared with the 150,000 prisoners who were killed at the Chongchroy prison and his and the chief of that prison still enjoy freedom or the impunity. So if that chief of the prison remain at large, then Deutsch should also remain at large. Because they were the chiefs of the prisons. If they were to be prosecuted, then everyone shall be equally prosecuted.
Why
some chiefs of prisons were prosecuted while the other were not? So how can we call this justice? And how can justice be done and seem to be done?
Justice et comment est-ce que on peut faire
this is the role of the co-prosecutors. At the beginning of the hearing on the 30th of March 2009, the first hearing, I asked the co-prosecutor to indicate clearly the reason why the co-prosecutor failed to prosecute the other prisoners of other prisons, because only having prosecuted those people that the victims of the regime are satisfied or are informed or relaxed having heard it, because those perpetrators finally ended up being prosecuted. The second point is in relation to the purpose of the royal government of Cambodia. The government intends to make sure that the trial is the court is established so that to stop such crime from occurring. Again.
Empêcher la
so,
répétition de tel crime. Par conséquent, la question est la suivante.
People who
si
killed more victims are still at large, but people
plus,
who killed less
de victimes sont toujours en liberté,
prosecuted,
et que des
is it a good message to the public that
sont traduits en justice. Est-ce que c'est juste? Est-ce que cela sert cet objectif du gouvernement que justice
and,
soit
if the accused is prosecuted, then it would be a violation to the constitution of the Kingdom of Cambodia, Article 31, and also the law of the ECCC itself.
And
if
Deutsch,
as the chairman of S21, were regarded as the person who was most responsible or senior people
or responsible
for the crimes,
des hauts dirigeants. donc responsable des crimes, à ce moment-là, les directeurs de ces 195 autres centres de détention doivent également être considérés, eux aussi, comme tombant dans la catégorie des principaux responsables. Et par conséquent, en violation des droits national et international, ils doivent être traduits en justice devant ces chambres. C'est seulement en faisant ce travail de justice que l'on arrivera à une équité. Si on n'inclut pas ces 195 autres chefs de centre de détention dans la catégorie des principaux responsables des crimes, à ce moment-là, pourquoi est-ce que le directeur de S21 devrait être traduit en justice et pourquoi devrait-il faire partie de cette catégorie ? Et donc traduit en justice.
I therefore request
Par conséquent,
for the exemption of such prosecution against my client, Kanke Elias Deutsch. I would like now to reiterate that the chief of the 195 or 96 prisons, none of them had the authority to make any arrests, interrogate, and smash. They received order from the four groups, as I already indicated.
They received order from those four groups.
Why he was now, or why he receives the falling stone?
Alors, pourquoi est-ce que c'est Duc qui reçoit? Pourquoi
so
lui reçoit-il
should also consider whether they now,
tête, ce coup qui lui est asséné? Pourquoi lui
et pas les autres? Or exempt the prosecution of Deutsch or otherwise prosecute other
on exempte toute poursuite, soit on traduit en justice les chef des 195 autres centres
the
de
law
détention.
States clearly that only Cambodia. The senior leaders of the Khmer Rouge regime and those who were most responsible would be brought to trial. And those who are not included in this category would be free or regardless of their having committed such crimes, having killed hundreds of people. This law is very special. It is very extraordinary, I may say, because it is contradictory to the code, the domestic code, which is about the accomplices, the perpetrators, and those who were aiding and abetting the crimes all have to be prosecuted. Now, the law only allows the prosecution of those who were most responsible for the crimes and the senior leaders of the Khmer Rouge regime. And if you look at the situation of Deutsch, Deutsch was the chairman at S21. He did not kill people in person. He had his subordinates smashed those people and the chief of his subordinates who were the direct perpetrators are not prosecuted. They only prosecuting the senior, the most senior one. So the lower cadre, lower level cadre would not be prosecuted as the law says. So if the prosecutors indicate or determine Deutsch or put Deutsch into any categories of these two groups of people, then the prosecutors should now tell the court clearly how we can really identify the status of the most responsible people of, for the crimes and the senior leaders. So without doing so, the question, there would never be justice. And that If
il n'y a pas lieu de poursuivre doute.
It makes my client fall victim as a loyal servant of the regime.
Mon client est victime.
And he is not clear as to what kind of status he should be classified in. And therefore, the co-prosecutors shall have the position to clearly indicate who were those most responsible people and senior leaders. Others, cadre, the former cadre of Khmer Rouge regime, have been living with this kind of uncertainty. During Khmer Rouge regime, when the people were arrested and sent to S21, no one would be spared, regardless of the arrest that was made by mistake. The ANCA would say that killing someone by mistake is better than releasing someone wrongfully. Or to kill you is no loss, or to keep you is no gain, or to lose you is no loss, as such.
So
it can be concluded that S21 had no authority to make any decision to arrest or to release anyone. S21 killed people, and the photos of the dead bodies had to be taken and sent to Pol Pot to make sure that he believed those were killed. Pol Pot did not trust anyone easily. So my client just obeyed the order of the ANCA. If he failed to do so, he would have been implicated as the enemy of the ANCA. So he had to do his best to survive by respecting the order. Of course, it is no doubt that at S21 there was execution, but those who directly killed the prisoners were the guards, in which Kumbak, alias Hoare, who was in charge of the unit. So Deutsch never killed, never smashed any prisoner in person. The most responsible people those who were most responsible for crimes all across the country were those who made the decision to arrest and smash. So who made such decision? Who made the decision to smash?
Qui décidait d'exécuter?
They were the committee of the central, the steering committee, in which Pol Pot was the secretary. It was not
Deutsch.
I therefore submit that Deutsch did not commit the crimes against humanity or the war crime as being charged. The ECCC law states that only those who were most responsible for the crimes and senior leaders of the Khmer Rouge regime are to be prosecuted, and no medium or low-level cadres would be prosecuted because they just obeyed their superiors, and they had no choice but to obey it. During the Khmer Rouge regime, those who had come across the regime could have been quite familiar with the situation. Killing anyone at S21 is no different from killing other people all across the country. This killing was conducted by the Communist Party of Cambodia, led by Pol Pot, not by my client, Duch. So it is a mistake to prosecute my client now. It is good if that the real senior and most responsible people for the crimes are prosecuted. It is too bad that these people could never stand trial. They died too early.
Beaucoup de ces principaux responsables sont morts trop tôt.
Elias Mok arrested Pol Pot and that he died, and people started to realize that they should now put the rest of the people on trial. So according to the history of the history, the prosecution of the Hitler group and also the president of Chile and also the president of Mr. Slobodan Milosevic. These people were the real most responsible people for the crimes. Now, the court should have been quite informed already who were the senior leaders and most responsible for the crimes, who were the mastermind of the lines, the criminal lines, and they were Pol Pot and their people and his people. And I think prosecuting just Pol Pot alone would be significant already, as he was the real mastermind. According to the Penal Code of 1956, the crimes committed, or the crimes that had been committed at S21, were not included in that Penal Code, because the article states that it cannot be regarded as the crimes, criminal offenses, if the crimes were committed based upon the order of the superior.
Sous les ordres d'un supérieur.
And in the rule of law, we should stick to this rule. And according to the law during the Khmer Rouge, the Pol Pot's rule and law, when people were sent to S21, it was the party, it was the Ankar who made the decision to smash or to execute them. At that time, the party was the court. The speech of the party was equivalent to the final judgment of current court. No one could contest. Whatever order rendered by the party, everyone had to be abided by it. Only after the Khmer Rouge regime that people could challenge, people could never do that in the Khmer Rouge regime. And I wish they could do so in that regime, if they would wish to do so, and I believe that they would end up being smashed if they did so. So if the Ankar asked someone to be smashed, then they have to be smashed. If they opposed, then they would be regarded as enemies. An enemy had to be smashed.
Éventuellement, cette exécution était lui-même considéré comme un ennemi exécuté à son tour.
It was in the proceedings that the witnesses who talked about the parents who came to see the children, and the children were happy to see their parent coming home, but the children was proud to tell the parent that According to Anka, you were my parent, but then
des familles, des enfants,
killing
des parents
was no different. And who ordered such?
Les enfants étaient séparés de leurs parents et ils se pouvaient même
execution. It was Sun Sen. It was Sun Sen. On top of Sun Sen was Nguyen Chi. On top of Nguyen Chi was Pol Pot, and so on and so forth. So Sun Sen, Nguyen Chi, and Pol Pot were the legal authority of the Democratic Kampuchea. Because during that time, Democratic Kampuchea was the legal state recognized by the United States, United Nations. The United Nations still recognized the Democratic Kampuchea as a state, the legal, legitimate state,
comme état légitime
long after the collapse of the regime.
Après la chute du régime.
So we can see that the Democratic Kampuchea was the legitimate rule, the country. Recognized by China, France, and allowed Pol Pot to have a seat at the United Nations. So Pol Pot was Pol Pot's hand was sustained with blood, but still the United Nations allowed him to have a seat, a place in such internationalized body.
Dans une enceinte internationale.
We, the Defense Council, admitted the crimes at S21, like the crimes committed at other prisons,
tout comme des crimes ont été
existed.
Commis dans d'autres centres de détention.
You cannot cover an elephant with a rice basket.
Un
the accused
avec
has
un
repeatedly
panier.
Made it clear. Two
fois.
Leaves of tamarind
et deux feuilles
could
de
never be used to cover the dead elephant. So who are to be brought for
alors,
or be accountable for the crimes?
Tenu
according to our ancient practices, it was those who ordered the killing would be brought to trial.
Qui doivent être traduits.
Article 238 of the Penal Code states that if the criminal only obeyed his superior under duress. For example, like Deutsch. Deutsch had to really obey Sun Sen's orders. So in such a case, the prosecution could only be brought against the superior. The superior who ordered such execution. So Rule 238 can be a good reference for this. So if the boss ordered to commit such crimes, then the boss shall be prosecuted for the commission. Even in the United States, there was an execution of the person who set the house on fire.
Pour avoir mis le feu à une maison.
During the Sangkum Rihniyum, Priap N was executed. Makara was also executed. Those who were allowed to execute those people were not prosecuted because they were allowed by law.
Car c'était des exécutions qui étaient faites.
So those who just obeyed the superior order would be spared from being prosecuted.
Ne doivent pas
and my client falls in that category. The Defense Council have examined and found out that Deutsch should be free from being prosecuted because if he failed to abide by the order, he would have been prosecuted by the Penal Code of 1956 because if he failed to respect the order, according to that order, article, in the Khmer Rouge regime,
sous le régime Khmer
if Dutch failed to obey the orders, he would have been smashed already or long ago.
Exécuté. Circonstance prévue par le code pénal.
Only in the case when the
ce n'est que
chamber has found out that Dutch has exercised his authority or abused his power
de son autorité,
or he did more than what he was ordered to do,
plus que ce qui lui a été ordonné de faire,
that he would be prosecuted according to
qu'il est possible de
Article 240 of
en vertu de l'article 240 du code pénal de 1956.
So only in that case
ce n'est que
that
dans ce
Dutch
cas
could be prosecuted.
Que Dutch peut être poursuivi.
According to Article 5,
en vertu de l'article 5,
on the outlaw of the Khmer Rouge,
de la loi qui déclare hors la loi,
the article states clearly that
on peut lire
this law
que
allows 6 months after it comes into existence or in force
the forces loi,
who were in the democratic Cambodia to return or to surrender to be integrated under the supervision of the kingdom of the Kingdom of Cambodia, those who could turn in within this period of time would be exempt from being prosecuted.
Pendant lesquelles les personnes qui réintégreraient
so those people who were the members of the political group or who belonged to the Democratic Cambodia and who came or integrated into the society with the royal government of Cambodia before the 7th of January 1995 were not charged or prosecuted under this law.
En vertu de la loi de 95.
So, having considered this law, my client has genuinely been free from being prosecuted already.
N'a pas été inquiété.
And he came to
et
join the government long before such the law established.
Bien avant cette loi de 95.
He came 2 years, 6 months before the law
deux ans et
was
six mois,
adopted.
Pour être précis, avant que la loi ne soit adoptée.
So whatever crimes he
donc, quel que soit le crime
could have committed,
qu'il ait pu
he
commettre,
shall not be prosecuted
il ne va pas non plus
based on this article.
Au vu de cet article de la loi de 95.
As the court is already informed that according to the law on the outlaw of the Khmer Rouge and from the date this law came into force, which was 1995, so if any individual who was the member of the political organization or in the military of the Democratic Cambodia who failed to integrate into the royal government of Cambodia and who continue to exercise its execution or killing of people, then the law
délictueux,
can be used to prosecute those people.
Pour poursuivre ces personnes.
And of course, they have violated this article.
Parce qu'ils auraient été en contravention avec l'article 5 de la loi.
But so far,
mais,
and in 1997, Pol Pot arrested Son Sen, Yon Yat, and the whole family, 11 people. And have them shot at.
Tous les membres de sa famille a été assassiné.
And that they were lie down on the road while the tank was seen
et
rolling
corps,
on them. And it is It was a very heinous crime, and these people could have been prosecuted for such crime, but who could prosecute Pol Pot at that time? At that time, only Ta Mok. He conducted a meeting and arrested Pol Pot and placed him under a house arrest and to inflict him the harsh condition and put him in the room which was so stuffy and hot to make sure that Pol Pot died sooner.
Sans aération.
So this is a crime. Pol Pot died. Ta Mok was free.
Pol Pot est mort. Ta Mok est resté libre.
I therefore submit that Doge is not guilty, and he shall be free from being prosecuted. From 1995, from 1995, Doge has never violated this law. And according to the same law, one article states that those senior leaders of the Democratic Cambodia are not pardoned. So the law states that according to this conclusion, Doge was not among the most responsible people or senior leaders.
Il ressort de tous ces éléments que Doge ne faisait pas partie des hauts responsables ni des hauts dirigeants ni des principaux responsables.
If we refer to the appeal of the Royal Government of Cambodia, the appeal signed by some Dutch Co-Prosecutors, the first Prime Minister and the second Prime Minister, Mr. Hun Sen, signed in 1994 to appeal to the people, the soldiers who were still under the supervision of Khmer Rouge to surrender, to integrate in the society. The government at that time promised not only to pardon them, but to maintain their previous rank and status.
Dans leur rang et leur statut
now,
intérieur.
At the Ministry of Defense,
there
are still some former Khmer Rouge soldiers with the same rank. Unfortunately, Doge, who came to live with under the supervision of the government long before the outlaw, the Khmer Rouge outlaw law adopted, end up being prosecuted. So this is a clear message that
Doge
is not a person who is stubborn or violates the law, because he even came to live with the government long before the law was adopted or before he heard the appeal.
Ou dès avant l'appel lancé par le gouvernement.
So Doge came very early already. He should Doge have been appreciated. And he did not commit any crime for that certain reason. So he should be free. And the court may consider this case as well. And according to the Paris Peace Accord of the 23rd of October 1991 concerning Cambodia, Article 21 of that agreement,
de l'accord, se reprend l'interprète.
It states that the release of the prisoners and detained prisoners
personnes détenues
are to be determined in due course
doit faire l'objet d'une décision en temps utile le plus rapidement possible.
There were factions, there were troops, there were civils who were trapped in
the
and then when UNTAC came, they were released, and people could come to sit on at the table at Jakarta, for example, at New York, and these people were equal before the law, and all past crimes or matters were forgotten. And according to this period, Annex 5 of this agreement states clearly that the institution prohibits any execution of the criminal law on the crimes that committed in the past. So in 1991, the Paris Agreement, which established United Nations Transitional Authority in Cambodia, or UNTAC, in 1973, has pardoned and recognized the Khmer Rouge as a party in the election. Because if they were regarded as the convict, then they would not be allowed to take part in such an election. At that time, the Khmer Rouge were allowed to take part, but they boycotted such election. And Deutsch was not part of any leaders, of the Khmer Rouge leaders, so there has no more remaining offenses to be left, and that he shall not be prosecuted. I therefore request that the trial chamber accept the motion of the defense concerning the termination of the criminal action as prescribed or pursuant to Article 500, 501 and 506 of the Criminal Code or Penal Code of 1956, or declare
that
there
500, 501 et 506 du Code pénal de 1956.
The armed conflict,
pour ce qui concerne le conflit
which
armé,
led to the war crime, which violates the Geneva Convention, dated on the 12th of August 1954, was the part of the government of the Democratic Cambodia and those of the Socialist Republic of Vietnam. The conflict was between them, and it was not Khan Kek Eo alias Deutsch who started it. It was the Communist Party of Cambodia and the government of Democratic Cambodia who made the decision to send Vietnamese soldiers and civilians to be smashed at S21. Khan Kek Eo alias Deutsch did not have authority to make such decision. Therefore, it is not Khan Kek Eo alias Deutsch personally, but the Communist Party of Cambodia and the government of Democratic Cambodia who violated the Geneva Convention of the 12 August 1944. So I request that Deutsch is now free from being prosecuted. Thank you, Your Honor. I would like to share the floor with my co-counsel.
The President,
Mr. François Roux, you may now proceed with your final closing statement.
De manière à vous permettre de procéder à votre plaidoirie.
Merci, Monsieur le Président, mais étant donné l'heure, je souhaiterais pouvoir commencer demain matin pour ne pas m'interrompre dans à peine une demi-heure, si la Chambre le veut bien. Je n'imagine pas faire seulement mon introduction maintenant et poursuivre demain
like
matin.
To do my introduction now and continue with the rest of my pleadings tomorrow morning.
The President, as requested by the Defense Council, and due to
Maître Roux vient de nous demander
the time limit, because we only have 15 minutes left for the session to end, so we now grant the Defense Council such a request, and that he shall be making his pleading tomorrow session.
Le Conseil de la Défense
we will now adjourn the
et commencer sa plaidoirie demain matin.
Session
nous allons
by now and we will
lever l'audience
the session by 9 a.m. tomorrow.
Et nous reprendrons
the security personnel are now instructed to take the accused back to the detention facility and return him to the courtroom by 9 a.m.
Au centre de détention et de le ramener dans cette enceinte d'ici 9 h demain matin. L'audience est levée. La greffière, mesdames et messieurs, veuillez vous lever.